so without further ado, for somebody that is open for other shows such as Willie Nelson, Randy Travis, and the Oak Ridge Boys, this is 2004 Christian Country Music Association Entertainer of the Year. This is Clifton Jansky.
Thank you, Gary. Good to be in Idaho Falls, Idaho tonight. Well, the view's so good from where I've been sitting. I'm alone on my self-made fence. Going along to get along, seem to serve me never. Making waves, trying to fit in. I was sitting so high above all the others, trying to make sense out of circumstance. One foot on the right and one on the other, never taking a stand, just a riding the fence. Until one night I was being tempted to put both feet in the lion's den. The spirit of the Lord brought me to my senses and said, you can't serve me and keep riding the fence. Get off the fence.
Get off the fence.
Be a different man.
Make a difference.
Get off the fence. For the time is drawing near, when the Son of Man will come in the clouds, together on home with some solid ground. Take my advice, don't think twice.
Get off the fence.
Here comes some Christian country fiddle now. Corey, I need to do this right. Start walking in the light. Little eyes are watching everything you do. So get off of the fence and live a life that's true. Get off the fence.
Get off the fence.
Make a difference.
Make a difference.
Get off the fence.
Get off the fence.
All the time is going near. The Son of Man will come in the clouds. Together on home we'll live on solid ground.
Look out for that barbed wire.
Man, I needed y'all all last year. Are y'all ready to have some fun tonight? There's a lot of people think you can't have fun in church. And you can look at their expression and wonder why. Not wonder why, anyway. But I am from San Antonio, and it's great to be here in Idaho Falls. And I did a Valentine's banquet in a little town called Uvalde, Texas, which is a whole lot smaller than Idaho Falls. And I sat across the table from a guy, and he told me that he had had a heart transplant And the chances of me sitting across the table from the guy that's had a heart transplant in Uvalde, Texas, are zero. On the way home, God spoke to my heart and said, everybody needs a heart transplant, but not one you can get from the doctor or the hospital. And this one, you don't have to worry about the charges because the charges were paid in full. You don't have to worry about Medicare, Obamacare, Bidencare. You don't have to care about nothing because Jesus paid the price, the great physician. And this was our first number one song in Christian country music.
Disease going round that affects the heart. Bible says everyone has it. The incurable terminal disease and sin that the doctors can't seem to handle. It destroys the heart, the mind, body, and soul, and leads to eternal destruction. And the only cure is for Jesus Christ to replace that old heart with a new one. A heart transplant from the great physician. I need a heart transplant. Mine's in bad condition. I need a clean, pure heart for one that is wicked. Lord, I'm in your hand.
I need a heart transplant.
Waiting list for this transplant, and the charges are paid in full. But Jesus paid the price for our sinful hearts, and he died for me and you. And when we by faith open our hearts to him, Jesus makes everything new. So if you want a new life with a brand new heart, Jesus needs to hear from you. A heart transplant from the great physician. I need a heart transplant. Mine's in bad condition. I need a clean, pure heart for one that is wicked. Lord, I'm in your hands. A heart transplant. A heart transplant. I need a heart transplant. Magic.
No, being it snowed so much in San Antonio, I may have to move to Idaho Falls. Y'all are just a great crowd. My goodness. I want us to do this song together. Y'all know how to sing this song. It's a little Craig Crowder music, but I just want people to know that my only hope is in Jesus. All my hope is in Jesus. I didn't know who he was. I was 27 years ago. I never read the Bible till I was 27. Didn't know what Christmas was about, what Easter was about. But now I do, and he changed my heart and my life. On May the 3rd, 1984, at 11:45 p.m. in the evening in a little farmhouse in Sutherland Springs, Texas, and I've never been the same since.
I've been here by I feel far from above. I've been down to that river. I ain't the same, a prodigal return.
Sing it with me tonight.
All my hope is in Jesus.
stranger to the prison. I wore shackles and chains, but I've been freed and have y'all been freed and forgiven? I ain't going back, I'll never be the same. Sing it with me now. There's a kind of thing that just breaks a man, breaks him down to his knees. God, I've been working more than a time or two, but you pick me up and show me what it means to be a man. Sing it with me. Thank you. Jesus. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. You can handle this world. Give me Jesus. When I come to die, when I come to die, when I come to die, just give me Jesus. That's not just a song for me. That's what I want. I mean, I tell you what, I've never seen the world in such a mess in all my life. People ask me, well, how old are you, Clifton? I said, I'm 4 years younger than George Strait. I'm 64, so paint the picture. Okay, there you go. You're a youngster. Amen. Thank you. So you may be saying, well, how did Clifton Jansky get to Idaho Falls, Idaho? Well, I'm fixing to tell you. Where's Tim at? Where's right there? Okay. So Tim's dad used to pastor a church in Converse, Texas, right around San Antonio. And I did actually a Valentine's banquet at the church, and then they asked me to go on a cruise with them the next year and just sing a few songs and cruise around, and I thought that's a great idea. And then Tim was a police officer there in San Antonio for many years, and then he pastored a little church outside of La Vernia, Texas. And there was a church called Elm Creek Baptist Church. And I'm trying to, was it 1893, 1863 when it was? 1893. And I was over in Macedonia in 1997, and I was with a guy named Sammy Tippett, and he was writing a book. Now, this was 1997. He was writing a book called Choices. And it was the fact that America had to make a choice of either choosing the blessing of God or the wrath of God. This was 1997. And as he began to share that book with me, I began to write a song. He'd share a little more, and I'd write another verse. Got back, we did a CD in 1997, and the church that Tim pastored is the church that's on the front cover of that CD. So how about that? You didn't know that till... He didn't even know that. I think we've only got four left out there, but anyway, I made sure and gave you one. But our country needs Jesus. Our families need Jesus. Our country needs Jesus. Washington, D.C. needs Jesus. Texas, Idaho, all of them need Jesus. He's our only hope. And this song says, Lord, would you bring us back? Bring us back to the days when God's way was the way that we lived. And our standard of righteousness was from God's word and not just politically correct. Somebody say amen. When godly men had godly homes and taught their children right from wrong, and the marriage vow was meant to last. Oh, bring us back.
Bring us back, oh Lord.
Oh Lord, bring us back.
Bring us back, oh Lord.
Bring us back to the days when God's word was the law of the land. And the phrase "in God we trust" was not just words on money, but a rock on which to stand. When it was legal to pray in school, and babies were safe in their mother's womb, and we loved our neighbor as ourselves. Oh, bring us back.
Bring us back, oh Lord.
Oh Lord, bring us back.
Bring us back, oh Lord.
And we strayed so far from your holiness that we're in the path of your righteous wrath. Oh Lord, help our country repent and return. Let the fire of revival begin to burn. Oh, bring us back.
Bring us back, oh Lord.
Oh Lord, bring us back.
Bring us back, oh Lord.
Bring us back to the days when God's church had the power and not just land. And pastors preach the word bold and true, fearing God more than man. When people serve no matter the cost, souls were saved that once were lost, and the body of Christ was in one accord. Bring us back.
Bring us back, oh Lord.
Oh Lord, bring us back.
Bring us back, oh Lord.
Bring us back the days when God's will for our lives was enough. We didn't need fortune and fame, they never want to know our name. We just follow God. When hearts were pure and motives right, serving Jesus was our delight. We walked by faith and not by sight. Oh, bring us back.
Bring us back, oh Lord.
Oh Lord, bring us back. If we humble ourselves and seek your face, and as a people turn from our wicked ways, you'll forgive our sin and heal our land. Oh, please let your glory fall again. Oh, bring us back. Back. Oh Lord, bring us back.
Bring us back, oh Lord.
Oh Lord, bring us back.
Bring us back, oh Lord.
Oh Lord, bring us back.
Bring us back, oh Lord.
Oh Lord, bring us back.
Bring us back, oh Lord.
I know you can.
Bring us back.
You know, I love the pastor's sermon this morning, and actually both Pastor Scotty and Pastor Ty were sharing the same scripture. I asked Pastor Scotty, I said, did you know he was preaching that? And he said, no, I didn't. I said, well, God was both times. I got both barrel loads. But Jesus told the disciples that they're going to get in the boat and they're going to go to the other side. And that's what Jesus has told every one of us. We're going to get to the other side. It doesn't matter what's all going right now in our nation and all going everywhere. We're going to get to the other side. He's already promised that. We just got to walk it out. We got to love folks. We got to love folks we don't like. We got to love folks that don't believe the way we believe. We got to love folks, and we got to just say, Jesus, take me to the other side. Amen? And I want to share a little bit. Like I said, November 17th, 1983, somebody pulled up with a stolen van and they cut the lock on my trailer hitch that had Clifton Jansky and the Drifters of San Antonio on it, and they stole everything I owned in country music. Over $20,000 of equipment then, but it's probably about $100,000 now. And then a month and a half later, I moved over to the northeast side of San Antonio and I went through a divorce because I was married by a preacher that never told me I was supposed to have a relationship with Jesus before I had a relationship with a wife. And you don't learn that in the honky-tonks and dance halls of South Texas. So I went through that, and then I was invited to a Bible study at my uncle and aunt's house on the northeast side. And there was a 72-year-old deacon in a Baptist church that invited me. And that was not on my bucket list, folks. A Bible study was not on my bucket list. But I went. I pulled this Bible out that I'd been given when I was 10 years old with a zipper on it. It was a King James zippered Bible. Some of y'all remember those. And I had my name down in the right-hand corner, but I'd never unzipped it. So I unzipped it, and I went to that Bible study, and I began to hear about Jesus for the first time in my life. And, you know, I'm kind of a hard-headed bohemian, so it just didn't drop automatic here. And the more I learned, the more I begin to hear these things like all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Folks, I was senior class president and valedictorian of my class in San Antonio. Now, there's not too many country singers that can say that. Amen? And but I didn't know anything about God, and I began to learn. I began to hear things in God's word, and that Jesus loved me. God loved me so much, He gave His only begotten Son, that if I would believe in Him, I would not perish but have everlasting life. And those things I got in here, they began to drop. And then my Aunt Joyce thought that I had become a Christian by going to a Bible study. And I told the cowboy church, that's like thinking you become a hamburger if you go to McDonald's. I mean, I had not received Jesus. I was not a Christian, but she said, would you come sing at our church? We're having a revival. And I said, Aunt, I don't know any songs. Folks, literally, I did not know one gospel. I didn't even know Jesus loves me. I didn't know He loved me, and I didn't know the song either. And she taught me two songs. She said, you can sing this one right here. Everybody knows this one. I said, speak for yourselves. The song was Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I didn't know the words. I didn't know the tune. And most of all, I didn't know I was a wretch yet. So I showed up at her house on May the 3rd, and I said, Aunt Joyce, do I have to say anything when I get up there? She says, just give part of your testimony. Well, I didn't have one. I didn't know what one was. So I got up there. About 40 senior adults were in this little church, and I said, my name is Clifton Jansky. I've been singing country music all my life. This is the first time I've ever sung for the Lord. Sung at three songs, put the guitar in the case, and shut up and sit down, scared to death. Went back to their house, and they began to just tell me how real God was in their lives and in my cousin's lives. And it was 11:45 p.m., May the 3rd, 1984. I interrupted my uncle in the middle of a sentence, and I said, Uncle, I want to be saved right now. And I got on my knees and my legs and my heart. And at that point, country music didn't matter. Relationships didn't matter. Nothing mattered. I had to take my eyes off all my yesterdays, all my todays, and all my tomorrows, and put them totally on Jesus. Until you do that, He can't come in, folks. He's a jealous God. And so I put my eyes on Him. I felt like I weighed 3 ounces after praying that prayer. He lifted the burden of my sin. I've never been the same since. And yes, the devil has tried to shut me up numerous times, but I've got a smile on my face tonight. I'm telling and singing people about Jesus. So God is good and he's faithful. I played a club called the Blue Bonnet Palace in Selma, Texas, right outside of San Antonio. I played there twice a month for 12 years. And that's where I opened for people like Eddie Rabbit and Gary Morris and Lee Greenwood. There was a marquee out there, so my name was on that marquee 2 out of 4 weeks for 12 years. And I believe there was a lot of people driving by that dance hall, and they were maybe some Christians were going, I can't believe that guy's out there sending everybody to hell singing that country music. But then I believe there was some wonderful Christian people driving up down 35 and looked at my name and said, Lord, would you save that young man? Would you change his life that one day he'd be singing your praises? So tonight I stand here. I'm a walking, talking, real live answered prayer. And if you're here tonight, that's what you are. You're a walking, talking, real live answered prayer. Everything was going right. I had fortune and fame. Records playing on the radio. Everybody knew my name. I thought I had everything that I could ever hope to find. Little did I know that one day a prayer would forever change my life. Somewhere someone kneels to pray, and I cross their mind and lift my name to the Father's throne and ask Jesus to save my life. Circumstances begin to change, and there's an emptiness inside as I fall down on my knees of prayer. Is answered in God's time. Thank you for your prayers that saved my life. Thank you for your prayers to help me see the light. Thank you for the times you held and gave me to the Lord. I'm a walking, talking, real life answered prayer. Somewhere there's a scared young girl, hurting all alone, feeling shame and hopelessness, needing Jesus much more than she knows. She's been told that she has the right to choose her baby's life or death. She doesn't know what to do, but the answer will soon be made clear by the power of a prayer. Somewhere someone kneels to pray for a girl with an unborn child. They lift them both to the Father's throne and ask Jesus to save their lives. And somewhere outside a clinic today, a young girl chooses life. She'll give birth to her child and her heart to the Lord as a prayer is answered in God's time. Thank you for your prayers that saved my life. Thank you for your prayers you have to see the light. Thank you for the time you built and gave us to the Lord. And we're a walking, talking, real answered prayer. There's a daddy somewhere tonight running from the Lord. He's left his wife and his family in search of a brand new start. Looking for the easy way out from his problems and his cares. Little does he know that one day his plans will be altered by the power of a prayer. For somewhere his little daughter kneels and prays to the Lord to bring her daddy home again and make their family better than before. And somewhere in a lonely motel room, her daddy begins to cry. He goes home to the Lord and his family as a prayer is answered in God's time. But what if prayers don't seem to change the circumstance you're in? You must walk by faith and not by sight, trusting Jesus to do what's best. For faith is the key to answered prayer, so pray and please don't doubt that one day some real live answered prayers will come home and say to you in the Father's house, thank you for your prayers to save our lives. Thank you for your prayers to help to see the light. Thank you for the times you lived and gave us to the Lord. And we'll walk and talk in real life, answered prayers. Thank you, Lord. Talking real life, answered prayer. All of us are just a walking, talking real life, answered prayer. We'll spend eternity with all of our walking, talking real life, answered prayer. I was up in North Texas, and in North Texas, like above Amarillo, they really talk kind of funny up there. They make one-syllable words two syllables. So I was singing at a church there, and the pastor and his wife said, hey, Brother Jansky, you want to go get a bite to eat? And I said, sure. So I got in the car, and their little boy, he was about 8 years old, got in the back seat with me. And he said, Mr. Jansky, did you write all those songs you were singing tonight? And I said, well, I said, not really. I said, Jesus gave them to me. I just kind of wrote them down. And he says, well, I guess you're kind of Jesus' secretary. I said, I guess I am. Amen. My dream as a six-year-old boy was to stand and sing on the Grand Ole Opry stage. When you're a country singer, that's just where you want to be. That's you know, and when I was 6 years old, that's what I wanted to do. That's what I wanted to be. And started playing guitar when I was five and a half. My first band, I had a band called the Texas Half Pints. I was 11. The guitar player was 11. And the drummer was an old man. He was 12. And we were making $75 to $100 a piece a night as 11-year-old kids. And so, you know, and then I recorded my first record when I was 17 years old and had 12 records on country radio. I never got picked up by record deal, record label. I've never had a promoter. I've never had a booking agent. I'm not complaining. I'm just saying I've had to do everything on my own, and it's okay. I know God had a plan, and I'm okay with that. But I still wanted to make to that stage, open for all those other guys. I actually opened for Willie Nelson, too, there in 1975, and I don't know if brag about that or not. But anyway, I think he just turned 147, I think, last week. Was his birthday. And, but, so I wanted to make it to that stage, and so, well, God, I'm kind of, okay, I'm getting ahead of myself, but anyway, so I came to know Jesus, and a lot of people think, well, when you come to know Jesus, you've arrived. You don't have to do anything now. You've arrived. You did it. No, you just got on the right team. You got on the winning team. You got out from the bleachers, and now you're on the playing field, and Jesus is the quarterback, the coach, and the manager. And so a month after giving my heart to Jesus, I felt like God was knocking on that country music door of my heart. Now, as Christians, we have choices to make. I could have said, God, you know this is my sole source of income. You're getting a little too personal here. But you know what I did? I fell on my knees, and in tears, I gave the Lord my country music career. And I said, Lord, if country music's not your goal for my life, I know you got something a lot greater. So use me where I'm at or take me out. And I'm here today because he did, and he did. July the 21st, 1989, I sang my final performance at the Blue Bonnet Palace, ending a 22-year career in country music. 5 days later, at a youth camp, God called me to full-time ministry, and I've been in full-time ministry now 32 years, yeah. Yeah, amen. And I probably lost count, but so when I got out of country music, I figured the dream of the Grand Ole Opry went out the door. And all of a sudden, that was 1989, I get a call from Nashville, 2001, 12 years later. And it's the president of the Christian Country Music Association, a guy named Gene Higgins. He said, Clifton, this is Gene Higgins. He said, hey, we want you to sing on the award show this year. I said, what? He said, we want you to sing on the award show. I said, what are you talking about? He said, you're up for 4 awards. I said, really? I said, where's the award show going to be held? He said, right here in Nashville. And I said, well, whereabouts in Nashville? He said, at the home of the Grand Ole Opry, the Ryman Auditorium. So November the 1st, 2001, God set me on that stage, and I won New Artist of the Year. I came back the next year, and I got to sing on the stage again, and I won Male Vocalist of the Year. And then in 2004, I was the only artist up for 5 awards, and Billboard Magazine, that does the articles on all the big boys, did an article on me in Billboard Magazine. And I was up for 5 awards, and with 2 minutes to go, I was 0-4. It was not looking good. But they opened up an envelope, and they said the 2004 Christian Country Entertainer of the Year is Clifton Jansky. And this is a song we played on that stage. I didn't have an iPhone band. I had a 10-piece band from Nashville. The guys that cut all the records with George Strait and Brad Paisley, they were my band for 3.5 minutes, and it didn't cost me a dime.
knees and pray. Shout it comes from the heart. When the Lord asks, do you love me? And you say yes, more than anything. Gotta come from the heart. Too many times empty words are spoken. That's why so many hearts are broken.
Just gotta come from the heart.
There's no other way. You gotta say what you mean to me. What you say. It's gotta come from the heart.
No other way. You gotta say what you mean and mean what you say. It's gotta come from the heart. It's gotta come from the heart. It's got to be real. Don't be afraid to say how you feel. It's gotta come from the heart.
From the soul.
It's gotta come from the heart.
From the soul.
It's gotta come.
Gotta come from the heart.
Man, I actually am considering moving here. I'm telling you, I'm just. Now, I told the pastor I was going to do kind of a song that you will not find in any hymnal. You see, I traveled about a 200-mile radius of San Antonio with my country band, but after I gave my heart to Jesus, I've been overseas 15 times. I've sung in the prisons for 24 years, and they keep letting me out. But I went with this guy named Sammy Tippett, and I was over in Romania and the Soviet Union in 1990, a year after the wall came down. We were doing some of the first open-air gospel meetings in stadiums. I remember in Arad, Romania, we had 20,000 people coming to the stadium, and it was like they were coming to a rock concert in America, but these people were so hungry. They were eight abreast coming to a stadium to hear about Jesus. And those, I consider myself very blessed and very fortunate because, you see, those days will never come again. That was a time when there was no Western influence in Romania and the Soviet Union, and the people were hungry. And I'm going to do this song, and then I'll do the other song I was getting ready to do. But when he asked me to go overseas with, he said, Clifton, he said, would you like to go overseas with me? I'm going to Romania and the Soviet Union. I said, Sammy, that'd be awesome. He said, well, it'd be nice if you could sing a song in Russian and Romanian. And I said, well, Sammy, I've never heard anybody speak it, let alone sing it. So he flew me to a Romanian family, and they had some youth from Romania there. I learned seven songs in Romanian, and I went to the Slavic Gospel Association in Chicago and learned three songs in Russian. And when I was in these stadium crusades and I was singing with 300-member choirs, they were singing the same thing I was singing. You might know this song. I want you to sing it with me. You can sing it in Romanian and English or whichever, but it's called How Great Thou Art. Universe. privesc ei o lumea ce ai creat-o prin al tău cuvânt. Și ființele ce împodobesc natura, cum le întreții cu brațul tău cel sfânt. Take away all our sin. Boy, when I first got in the ministry, I was at this church on a Sunday morning, and I asked the pastor, I said, Pastor, how long do you want me to go? He said, Brother Jansky, you can go as long as you want. We leave at 12. So I mean, this is my first time in 64 years to be in Idaho Falls. Y'all have time for a few more songs, or y'all listen? You know what? My booking agent, though, booked me a 7 a.m. flight. I have no idea how he did. It was me. Anyway, what's this? So here's a little song. It's not the only thing spiritual about this song is that I sing it with my tongue. So When I say that in Baptist churches, they ain't got a clue what I'm talking about. I was toting my bag along that dusty Idaho Falls road. When along came a semi with a hind canvas covered low. He said, if you're going to Water Springs Church, man, with me you can ride. So I climbed into the cab and I settled down inside. He asked me if I'd seen a road with so much dust and snow. And I said, listen, mister, I've traveled every road in this here land. I've been everywhere, man, I've been everywhere, man. Across the desert there, man, through the mountain there, man. I traveled, I've done my share, man, I've been everywhere. I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Lowell, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Audubon, Oklahoma, Panama, 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 Latin, Angel, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Domingilla, Ambiquilla, Ambadilla, Amaquilla, I've been everywhere, man. Man, cross the desert there, man. Through the mountain there, man. I traveled, I've done my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Austin, Charleston, Dayton, Louisiana, Washington, Houston, Kings of Texas, Canada, Monterey, Faraday, Santa Fe, California, Ben Black, Rock, Little Rock, Argo, Tennessee, Hennessy, Tippecanoe, Spirit Lake, Atlanta Lake, Devil's Lake, Crater Lake, Pete's Lake. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Cross the desert there, man. Through the mountain there, man. I traveled, I've done my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Louisville, Nashville, Knoxville, Loma, Bank, Shovelville, Jacksonville, Water, Castle, Rica, Pittsfield, Springfield, Bakersfield, Sweetwood, Hackensack, Cadillac, Pontiac, Bradford, Idaho, Jellicoe, Hodge, Adina, Dina, Dina, Pasadena, Catalina. See what I mean? I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Gone, visit there, man. Through the mountain there, man. I've traveled, I've done my share, man. I've been everywhere. California, Alabama, Louisiana, Idaho, Pennsylvania, Illinois, Alaska, New Mexico, Oklahoma, Minnesota, Arkansas, Florida, Scotland, England, Russia, Romania, Antarctica, Siberia, on the road, in the air, and Idaho falls out. Man, I believe you, man. Lost the desert there, man. Keep the mountain here, man. That's what I think I see, man. I believe you, man. Well, I have been just about everywhere you could imagine, from San Antonio, my home, all the way to Siberia. I went so far east one time, I had to fly west to get there. Now, those of you that flunked geography, let me just explain myself. So if you go east from San Antonio, you go like, you go across Mississippi and Florida, and then you go across that ocean, not sure which one it is. Then you go all the way over to England and Germany and Romania and Hungary and Soviet Union and Russia, and boom, then you finally make it to Siberia. Well, we went so far east, we went up through Anchorage, Alaska, and we crossed the Bering Sea, and we landed in a city called Yakutsk, Siberia. Minus 50. A couple of my buddies at home said, Clifton, was that a dry cold or a wet cold? I said, it really didn't matter. Don't put the pedal to the metal now. In the Chicago, Valgo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Arizona, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, local, Panama, 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 Appalachia, Mandeville, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Topeka, Ambiquilla, 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 some folks use a treadmill. I just sing this three times a week and it works. I've been everywhere. It will keep you skinny, that's something. Y'all wearing me out. I I wrote this song about 6-8 months ago, something like that, I don't know about you, but I've, sometimes Christian artists, singers get up and, you hear them sing and they, they're praising Jesus and you're walking through a storm. You got family problems. You got emotional problems. You got relational problems. You got all kinds of stuff going on. And you look up here and these guys all have a smile on their face and praise Jesus. And you're maybe sitting there and go, God, do you not like me? Why am I walking through this? Well, I just want you to know that I'm not exempt. I battled severe depression several years ago. And I wouldn't wish that on anybody. But in the midst of it, somehow, some way, Jesus brought me through. And I guess the encouragement tonight is, if Jesus can bring this old country singer through what I went through and put a smile back on his face, then there is hope for you. And that's what this song talks about. I've been up and I've been down, been lost and I've been found, been blind but now I see, in chains but now I'm free. But no matter where I am, no matter what I do, I know my Jesus will always see me through. 'Cause if he walked on the water, raised the dead, gave sight to the blind and healed the sick, he'll do the same. And you, I know my Jesus will always see me through. I've been rich and I've been poor, had enough and needed more. Walked through sunshine and rain, tasted victory and pain. But no matter where I am, no matter what I do, I know my Jesus will always see me through. 'Cause if he walked on the water, raised the dead, gave sight to the blind, and healed the sick, he'll do the same for me and you. Oh, my Jesus will always see me through. I've been good and I've been bad, been happy and I've been sad, had troubles and I've had peace, calm winds and stormy seas. But no matter where I am, no matter what I do, I know my Jesus will always see me through. 'Cause if he walked on the water and raised the dead, his sight through the blind and healed the sick, he'll do the same for me and you. I know my Jesus will always see me through. I know my Jesus will always see me through. I know my Jesus will always see me through. 'Cause if he walked on the water, he'd be dead. It's out to the and he'll do the same. He'll do the same for me and you. Oh, my Jesus will always see me through. Oh, my Jesus will always see me through. Oh, my Jesus will always see me through. Used to, they only hollered in the honky-tonks, but so I was at a church service a couple of weeks ago, and the pastor finished the sermon, And at the very end, he made this statement. And I'm sad to say, I don't really know what the rest of the sermon was about. But he made this statement. He said, if you ain't dead, God ain't done. If you ain't dead, God ain't done. So now every time you wake up from this moment on and you open your eyes, you're going to go, yes! He's not finished yet. So here's the song. That's hot off the press. You know, I believe there's no such thing as an accident with God. I believe he knew that I was going to be here tonight a long time before I knew it. And I know that he told Tim, or he knew that Tim was going to call me to be here a long, long time ago. And I like doing my life and my ministry in a way that c- causes the angels in heaven to rejoice. See, Jesus said, I tell you, there is rejoicing. There is in the presence of God's angels when one sinner repents, when one person gives their heart to Jesus. My entire life, I want to get excited about the things that heaven gets excited about. All the other stuff will just dwindle away. It'll burn away and go away. But I want to do this song to close tonight, and I apologize if I went a little long, but, you know, I got 300 more songs. So, but this song is called God's Song for You, and I remember I was doing this song for a Christian school, and there was a guy that was walking out as I was singing this song, and God had him stop right in his tracks. And God changed his heart that night, just stopped him right before he left the barn, and he gave his heart to Jesus. There are people that have been praying for this night. Might be a dad, it might be a mom, it might be a daughter, a son, grandchild, grandma, grandpa, that people have been praying for years and years, and all of a sudden, here it is. So when you're listening to this song, I want you to know that God gave me this song for you, for you, for you, for you, for you, for you.
Okay, now at this point in the program...
Country music. Now my life and songs have changed. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. And a river morning to amazing grace, so my first band at 11, my first record at 17. Had dreams of the Opry, as there was not meant to be. Little did I know God had a plan that was bigger than Tennessee. Idaho Falls. Church and on the street, every song I sing is God's to use, change hearts, set men free. Every open morning, amazing grace, so sweet. Every open morning, amazing grace, so. Amazing grace, how sweet.
Now, I told the people at Cowboy Church this morning, but y'all hadn't heard, son. How many Cowboy Church folks we got with us tonight? Anybody come from the Cowboy Church? Look at that. We got any visitors tonight? Any visitors? All right. Welcome. But I told them, I said, you know, I had a band for 22 years. We're called Clifton Jansky and the Drifters of San Antonio. But they always showed up late. They were always out of tune and always wanted more money. Now I carry my band and my iPhone. They're always in tune, always on time, and most of the time they play the right song. Heavy laden, troubled in your mind, sick and tired of being sick and tired, and running out of time. Are you lonely and discouraged? No friend to call alone. Then listen carefully. This might be your song. But there is one who knows your troubles. Yes, there is. There is one who truly cares. He gave all he had to give. Oh, but it didn't stop there. For he reached down to heaven. He cleansed my heart and he changed my life. He gave this song for me to sing. And if we will by faith see forgiveness by his blood, then we can be set free. What will be your answer to this song from God to you? Will you just listen to the words, or by faith follow through? Won't you bow your knees and heart? Call upon his name. For the moment that you do, you will never be the same. He'll give you peace you never knew. This is God's song for you. So please call upon his name. I've heard one pastor say, you know, I don't know much. He said, I'm just a blind beggar that knows where the bread is. But I do know that Jesus changes lives because he's changed mine. And folks, I'm going to be honest with you. I wasn't a drug addict. I wasn't an alcoholic. I mean, I had a lot of opportunity to smoke a lot of stuff like Willie does, but I never did. And I had a lot of other opportunities to do other stuff, but I was raised right by my mom and dad. I was taught yes, sir, and no, sir. And if I didn't say that, I got my little, you know, patter back there. So, I mean, I was a good person. So I was kind of at the top of the gutter of sin. Now, I knew a lot of other guys that were way down there. But you see, what I realized, it didn't matter if I was at the top of the gutter of sin or the very, very bottom of the gutter of sin. It takes the same Jesus to get me out. And sometimes it's a little harder for the people at the top of the gutter to realize they need Jesus because they got it going on pretty good. So I don't know where you are tonight. But the Bible says that all of us have sinned. Every one of us has sinned and fallen short of God's glory. And the wages of that sin is death, eternal separation from a holy God. But the free gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. And you know the verse, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever would believe in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. Folks, I am so just pumped today that my salvation is secure because it's based upon how good he holds on to me and not necessarily how good I hold on to him. Somebody say amen. God wants to come in some hearts tonight. We're not going to ask you to jump three rows of chairs, do a side straddle hop, anything. God wants to meet you right where you are. He met me right where I was. I didn't actually have to go to church to get Jesus. Wow. But he wants to meet you right where you are. So I'm going to ask us, I'm going to pray a similar prayer to what I prayed back in 1984. There's nothing magic about the prayer. The magic in the prayer was that I believed God was going to do what I asked him to do, and that's faith. Not believing God can do it. You can go to God and say, God, I believe you can save me. I believe you can change my family. No, it's God, I believe you can and you are and you're going to right now, and I give my life to you. There's a big difference. So I'm going to pray that prayer similar to what I prayed in 1984, and I just want all of us to say the prayer together. Now you say, well, why would I say that prayer? Well, I'm going to say it as a prayer of rededicating my life to Jesus. I'm not just leading you in a prayer. I don't know about y'all, but I need to be closer to Jesus every day. So let's pray. Lord, I just thank you for this evening, and I thank you for these next few moments. Lord, I pray that you would just, Holy Spirit, that you would go throughout this room right now, and people would sense a need for you that maybe they've never sensed before in their life. And that, Lord, they've just reach up and grab a hold of your nail-scarred hand and just give their hearts and life to you and let their life be changed tonight. March the 7th, 2021, they'd give their heart to Jesus. So let's just pray this prayer together. Just say, Lord Jesus, I love you. I love you more than anything. I believe that you're God's Son, that you died on the cross for my sin, and you rose from the dead on the third day. And with all my heart, right now, I receive you as my Savior and my Lord. And I receive forgiveness of every sin that I've ever committed. Thank you, Jesus, for loving me so much. You died for me. Help me to love you enough to live for you all the days of my life, in Jesus' name, amen. Pastor Scotty.
All right, well, hey, I just want to thank you again for coming tonight, and thank Clifton.
for just blessing us. It's been a blessing to get to know him. And so we're going to close out tonight. But if you prayed that prayer and you feel like you need somebody to kind of be your witness and confirm that with for you, there's going to be some pastors up here in a little bit when we dismiss. And so just feel free to come up. We're not going to bring any attention to it, but the pastors will be here if you need somebody to pray with you. And Clifton mentioned that it is God's free gift to us. It's free for us, but it wasn't free for him, mm-hmm. right? And so I just encourage you, grab onto that gift and don't ever let go. Amen? And so I'm just going to close with the word of prayer and ask you to join me. Father, we thank you tonight, Lord, that we could come and listen, Lord, and hear and be blessed. And Lord, that you're in this place and your spirit is bearing witness with our spirit. And Lord, you're going to lead us into all truth. And Father, I just pray for those who prayed for the very first time to receive you. Lord, that you would give them strength. Lord, that they would seek somebody out and seek that prayer, Lord, as two together agreed on any one thing, there you are in the midst, Lord. And so we pray for that tonight. And as we go from this place, that you would go with us and watch over us, Lord, and keep us, Lord, and lead us in all your ways. Father, that you would direct our steps. So we thank you tonight. Thank you again for Clifton. Pray your blessing upon him. Just pray that you would watch over him as he travels and he shares the good news. Lord, may we all lift our heads knowing our redemption draws near. And so we love you tonight and pray that you would bless our evening in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, I think, do you think he ought to do an encore? All right.
Do what? I didn't hear that. So publicly, I want to thank you, Pastor Scotty and Pastor Ty and Tim and Gary at the Rev. And just, it's been awesome. And also the lady that did that really nice artwork and made me look so handsome. I appreciate that. I want to challenge you, if you prayed that prayer tonight for the first time and you meant it, I want to challenge you to tell somebody about that decision before you go to sleep tonight. Before you shut your eyes, did you know many times husbands and wives have never shared their testimonies because they met in church and they just assumed? So tonight, before you go to sleep, share that decision with somebody. I'm going to pray that you're not going to be able to sleep until you share it. So when you're tossing and turning at 4 a.m. in the morning, call Brother Scotty or Pastor Ty. Don't call me, okay? So we got to close with Amazing Grace, don't you think? Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. The Savior is like me. I once was lost, but now I am found. Was blind, but now I see. Grace that taught my heart.
stand with me and sing that first verse? Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll plow in to that home on God's blessed shore. This life has grown, I'll fly away. Like a bird from prison bars has flown, I'll fly away. Oh, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. Might just be in the morning when I die. Thank you very much for having me. I appreciate it.